How can you ensure that your data is stored consistently and reliably across a distributed system? My name is Whitney Lee, and I'm a cloud developer here at IBM. etcd is an open source key value data store used to manage and store data that help keep distributed systems running. etcd is most well known for being one of the core components of Kubernetes, where it stores and manages Kubernetes state data, configuration data, and metadata. etcd can be relied upon to be a single source of truth at any given point in time. Today, I'm going to go over some of the features of etcd that allow it to be so effective in this way. etcd is fully replicated. This means that every node in an etcd cluster has access to the full data store. etcd is also reliably consistent. Every data read in an etcd cluster is going to return the most recent data write. Let's talk about how this works. etcd is built on top of the Raft algorithm that is used for distributed consensus. So let's make a very simple etcd cluster of only four nodes. An etcd cluster always has a leader, and then the other nodes in the cluster are followers. It's a key value data store. So in this case, at key one, we have the value of 7. Let's say a web application comes in and lets the leader node know at key one, we want to store the value of 17 instead of 7. The leader node does not change its own local data store. Instead, it forwards that request to each of the followers. When a follower changes its local data store, it returns that to the leader, so the leader knows. When our leader node can see that the majority of the nodes have been updated to the most current data, that's when the leader will update its own current data store and return a successful write to the client. Now, a client doesn't actually have to concern itself about which node in the cluster is the leader. The client can make read and write requests to any node in the cluster. So let's say this all happens over a matter of milliseconds, but let's say that the client makes a read request to the node that hasn't updated yet and says, what's the value at key one? Well, this follower node knows it's a follower node and knows it's not authorized to answer the client directly. So what it's going to do is forward that request to the leader node, which will then respond, the cluster's current value at key one is 17. And so it will get a response of 17 to the client. And that's how etcd is replicated. So every node in the cluster has access to the full data store, and it's consistent. Every data read is going to return the most recent data write. etcd is also highly available. This means that there's no single point of failure in the etcd cluster. It can gracefully tolerate network partitions and hardware failure too. So let's say that our leader node goes down. The followers can declare themselves a candidate. They'll hold an election where each one votes based on availability, and a new node will be elected the leader. That leader will go on to manage the replication for the cluster, and the data is unaffected. etcd is also fast. etcd is benchmarked at 10,000 writes per second. But that said, etcd does persist data to disk. So etcd's performance is tied to your storage disk speed. etcd is secure. etcd uses transport layer security with optional SSL client certificate authentication. etcd stores vital and highly sensitive configuration data, so it's important to keep it protected. Finally, etcd is simple to use. A web application can read and write data to etcd using simple HTTP JSON tools. So the other thing to talk about in etcd that's important is the watch function. Kubernetes leverages this. So as I talked about at the beginning, etcd stores Kubernetes configuration data and its state data. So etcd can use this watch function to compare these to each other. If they ever go out of sync, etcd will let the Kubernetes API know, and the Kubernetes API will reconfigure the cluster accordingly. Etcd can be used to store your data reliably and consistently across your distributed system. Thank you. If you have questions, please drop us a line below. If you want to see more videos like this in the future, please like and subscribe. And don't forget, you can grow your skills and earn a badge with IBM Cloud Labs, which are free, browser-based, interactive Kubernetes labs.